Hello friends, welcome to our channel Piping Mantra. In this video, we are going to discuss about storage tanks and its layouts. So, without wasting any time, let's see what the agenda for today's video is. We are going to discuss about different type of tanks, classification of petroleum, grouping of tanks, separation distance between tanks. We are not going to cover piping layout of storage tank in this video. For that, you should see our next video which we are releasing soon. So, let's begin. First question that comes to mind is, what does storage tanks contain? Storage tanks contains non-organic liquids like acid and alkalis, organic liquids like oil with petrol, diesel, naphtha, fuel oil or benzene, etc. and vapor and gas like LPG and LNG, etc. Storage tanks can be found in many industries like petroleum producing and refining, petrochemical and chemical manufacturing, bulk storage and transfer operations, other industries consuming or producing liquids and vapors. Now, let's discuss about different types of storage tanks. These storage tanks come in different size and shape. They can be underground, above ground, horizontal, vertical, and are made of concrete, stone, fiberglass, steel. First is atmospheric tank. The tank that operates at pressure levels ranging from atmospheric pressure to 0.5 psig are called atmospheric tanks. Next is cone roof tank. This is a low pressure vertical storage tank with a cone shaped fixed roof. Then comes horizontal tanks. Horizontal tanks are constructed such that the length of the tank is not greater than 6 times the diameter to ensure structural stability and integrity. Next is bullet petroleum. This is a high pressure horizontal storage vessel shaped like a bullet. It is usually preferred over the other types to store liquefied gases like petroleum, butane and ammonia, for which melting point is low. Now comes Horton sphere. It is a spherical vessel used for storage of high pressure liquid and gases. Its application is same as bullet. Next one is fixed roof tank. A fixed roof tank consisting of a cone or dome shaped roof that is permanently affixed to a cylindrical shell. A breather valve, that is pressure vacuum valve, commonly installed on many fixed roof tanks, prevents the release of vapors during very small changes in temperature, barometric pressure or liquid level. Fixed roof tanks without breather valves will generally be freely vented. Fixed roof tanks are typically used with products that have relatively low volatilities and flash points. Now comes floating roof tank. A floating roof tank consists of an open-topped, dome-shaped or cylindrical steel shell equipped with a roof that floats on the surface of a stored liquid. The roof rises and falls with the liquid level in the tank. There are two types of floating roof tanks. First is internal floating roof. Next is external floating roof. Internal floating roof tanks has both a permanent fixed roof and a floating roof inside the tank on the liquid surface, that is contact deck, or is supported on pontoons several inches above the liquid surface, that is non-contact deck. The internal floating roof rises and falls with the liquid level. External floating roof tanks are equipped with a rim seal system which is attached to the roof perimeter and contacts the tank wall. The rim seal system slides against the tank wall as the roof is raised and lowered. Floating deck is also equipped with fittings that penetrate the deck and serve operational functions. Next is double wall storage tank. A double wall storage tank has an inner wall to contain a liquid, an annular space usually filled with insulation, and outer wall for containment of spillage. The last one in this list is LNG storage tank. A liquefied natural gas storage tank or LNG storage tank is a specialized type of storage tank used for the storage of liquefied natural gas. LNG storage tanks can be found in ground, above ground, or in LNG carriers. The common characteristic of LNG storage tank is the ability to store LNG at the very low temperature of minus 162 degrees Celsius. LNG storage tanks have double containers where the inner container contains LNG and the outer container contains insulation material. Storage tanks located in a safe area and grouped or segregated according to the contents is called tank farm. Tanks containing hydrocarbons should be separated according to the flash point. According to the flash point, classification of petroleum products, dykewall and its height requirement. Now, let's see what a flash point is. Flash point of any petroleum liquid is the lowest temperature at which a liquid can give off vapor to form an ignitable mixture in air and gives momentary flash on application. The lower the flash point, the easier it is to ignite the material. Now, let's discuss about classification of petroleum products. Petroleum products are classified according to their closed cup flash points as given below. First is Class A petroleum. Class A petroleum are the liquids which have flash points below 23 degrees Celsius. Class B petroleums are the liquids which have flash point between 23 and 65 degrees Celsius. Class C petroleums are the liquids which have flash points between 65 degrees Celsius and 93 degrees Celsius. Excluded petroleums are the liquids which have flash points of 93 degrees Celsius and above. One thing to keep in mind is that in the following cases, above classification does not apply and special precautions should be taken as required. Where ambient temperatures or the handling temperatures are higher than the flash point of the product, it is not applied. Where products handled is artificially heated to a temperature above its flash point, the classification does not apply. Now, an area will be deemed to be hazardous where petroleum having flash point of below 65 degrees Celsius or any flammable gas or vapor in the concentration capable of ignition is likely to be present. Petroleum or any flammable liquid having flash point above 65 degrees Celsius is likely to be refined, blended, or stored at above its flash point. Liquefied gases like LPG and LNG does not fall under this classification but form separate category. Oil, acid, alkali is usually stored in vertical storage tanks designed as per American Petroleum Institute API 650. These tanks can have different sizes ranging from 2 to 60 meter diameter or more. They are generally installed inside containment basins called dike in order to contain spills in case of rupture of the tank. Petroleum storage tanks shall be in diked enclosures with roads all around the enclosure. Aggregate capacity of tanks located in one diked enclosure shall not exceed 60,000 cubic meter for a group of fixed roof tanks or 120,000 cubic meter for a group of floating roof tanks. If a group of tanks containing both fixed and floating roof tanks, then it shall be treated as a group of fixed roof tanks for the purpose of above limits. Diked enclosure shall be able to contain the complete contents of the largest tank in the dike in case of any emergency. Enclosure's capacity, that is its volume, L into W into H, shall be equal to or greater than the volume of the largest tank and tank pad volumes within the dike. And this calculation should be at least 10% more for safety purposes. A freeboard of 200 mm above the calculated liquid level shall be considered for fixing the height of the dike. The height of tank enclosure dike including freeboard shall be at least 600 mm and shall not be more than 2 meters above average inside the grade level. The minimum height of dike wall in case of excluded petroleum shall be 600 mm. The dike wall made up of earth, concrete, or solid masonry shall be designed to withstand the hydrostatic load. Earthen dike wall shall have no less than 0.6 meters wide flat section on top for stability of the dike wall. Height should not be less than 900 mm. Width to height ratio is 1.5:1. Now, let's talk about grouping. Grouping of petroleum products for storage shall be based on the product classification. Class A and or Class B petroleum may be stored in the same dike enclosure. Class C petroleum should preferably be stored in separate enclosure. However, where Class C petroleum is stored in a common dike along with Class A or Class B petroleum, all safety stipulations applicable for Class A or Class B respectively shall apply. Excluded petroleum shall be stored in a separate dike enclosure and shall not be stored along with Class A, Class B or Class C petroleum. In a dike, tanks shall be arranged in maximum two rows so that each tank is approachable from the road surrounding the enclosure. This stipulation need not to be applied to tanks storing excluded petroleum class. Tanks having 50,000 cubic meter capacity and above shall be laid in single row. Now comes firewalls. For class A, B and C petroleum, in a dyked enclosure where more than one tank is located, firewalls of minimum height of 600 mm shall be provided to prevent spills from one tank endangering any other tank in the same enclosure. A group of small tanks each not exceeding 9 meters in diameter and in all not exceeding 5000 cubic meter in capacity shall be treated as one tank for the provision of firewall. For excluding petroleum product storage, firewall shall be provided by limiting the number of tanks to 10 or the capacity of group of tanks to 5000 cubic meter, whichever is lower. Firewall of height should not be less than 300 mm. Now, let's talk about separation distances between tanks. The tank height shall not exceed 1.5 times the diameter of the tank or 20 meter, whichever is less. The minimum distance between the tank shell and the inside toe of the dyke wall shall not be less than half the height of the tank. Separation distances between the nearest tanks located in separate dykes shall not be less than the diameter of the larger of two tanks or 30 meters, whichever is more. There shall be access on all the four sides of each dyke area and roads should be linked to minimize the effect if one road is cut off during the fire. For larger installation where total storage capacity for class A and class B petroleum products is more than 5000 cubic meter or the diameter of class A or B product tank is more than 9 meters, minimum separation distances shall be specified in these tables. Distances given for the tanks are shell to shell in the same dike. In the table, X indicates suitable distances as per good engineering practices to meet construction, operational and maintenance requirements. Where star is marked, you should refer second table. For example, separation distance between class A or class B floating roof tank where diameter is up to 50 meter should be D plus D by 4 or minimum 10 meter. Where capital D stands for bigger tank diameter and small d stands for small tank diameter. You can find these tables in OISD 118. For smaller installation where total storage capacity of class A and class B is less than 5000 cubic meter and diameter of any tank storing class A and class B petroleum product does not exceed 9 meters, you can refer this table for separation distance. This table shall also be applicable for the installations storing class C petroleum. Excluded petroleums should be treated as class C petroleum for the purpose of separation distances shown in this table shall be applicable for the separation distances. So, that is it guys for today's video. We will come back soon with another interesting topic. So, till then stay tuned and keep on watching. If you have any queries or doubts, please write to us in comment section below. And please like, share and subscribe. Also, please click on that bell icon so that you can get notified every time we upload new content. Till next time, bye-bye, take care.